back to Bulldog Weekly. I'm your host, Margaret.
And I'm Aiden.
We got some pretty exciting segments for you this week. We are going to participate in the Oreo Challenge, meet another Bulldog Weekly host with Danielle, view a senior Who Am I project, and watch Aiden make food.
But before we get into all of that, here's Principal Mr. Duvall with the week ahead, and Athletic Director Bill Tilden with the Sports Rundown.
Hello everybody, welcome to the Rundown. It's Sunday, December 15th. We're getting close to our winter recess. It's the last week of school before vacation. Monday, December 16th, day 7 in our cycle. Not a lot happening. We could kind of use a slow day in a busy week. Tuesday, December 17th, day 8. We have our holiday concert at 7 p.m. in the auditorium. That'll be a great event for our students in fine arts. Wednesday, December 18th, day 1 in the cycle. Two field trips during the day. We've got a group going to Woods Hole, and we have another group going to Faneuil Hall. I think it's a music trip to Faneuil Hall and a science trip to Woods Hole. During the Bulldog block, Leah Thomas will be here. She's an old Rochester graduate that's going to talk about careers in the medical field. Thursday, December 19th, day 2, we've got our first home girls ice hockey game. They're going to play against Marshfield at Tabor Academy at 7:30 p.m. And Friday, December 20th, day 3 in our cycle, two home athletic events. First, 3:30, boys ice hockey versus Upper Cape at Tabor, and then boys basketball, 6:30 at home versus Seekonk. It's the 20th of December. We are then off for 2 weeks. It's the longest school vacation we've ever had. A two-week vacation. Enjoy, everybody. See you in the new year.
Nice toss, Mr. Duvall. One of your better tosses. It's been a crazy couple of weeks for these to start sports out. We've had Tabor's really been struggling to get their ice refrigerated. It's finally fixed. We're happy to be going back to Tabor so we can get some ice time in over there. All our sports seasons start next week, except for boys basketball, is tomorrow at Wareham. Should be a very exciting game. Hopefully we can get the dog pound over there to have a good time with the game. Everybody else will be going all week long next week. So you want to check out southcoastconference.org for all our schedules. Other than that, it's actually been pretty quiet. A great week, a couple weeks of practices. Kids have been fantastic. We're looking forward to seeing the ORC TV crew at some of our games, and we're even looking more towards next week getting to catch some hockey, some track on Saturday if you want to come see a noontime meet. But for that, it's quiet, and hopefully we'll have a whole lot of good news for you for next week. Thanks, and back to the Bulldog crew.
Thanks for the update, guys. Now on to our first segment.
This week, the Bulldog Weekly crew decided to try out the popular game formerly known as the Oreo Challenge. Let's see what happened.
Hey guys, what's up? I'm Brianna.
And I'm Danielle.
And we're gonna do the Oreo Challenge.
These are the Oreos.
Yes, so basically what it is you take an Oreo and you put it on your forehead and then you try to get it into your mouth without using your hands.
Very tricky.
Yeah.
Can I lift it? You gotta hold it. So satisfying.
I was gonna do that. It's fine.
Get to it.
All right, we're gonna go for it. Grab one. Okay, ready?
Nope.
Put it on your forehead.
Okay.
Three.
Hold
two.
On.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
Three, two, one.
It fell back.
Oh my gosh, I'm literally so close.
I can't move.
I got it. Thank you for watching the Oreo Challenge. It's been a lot of fun. I won. I'm the winner. Danielle's the loser. It was great. It's a lot harder than it looks. You'd think that it would be super easy, but it's not.
Brianna cheated. It was a lot of fun doing the Oreo Challenge with Brianna. I really enjoyed myself. Kids, don't try it at home. It's very dangerous.
This is for Danielle because
she promised.
She's been begging.
Not begging. Okay. This has been Oreos.
Wow, well that was sure interesting, wouldn't you say, Aiden?
It sure was, Margaret, but I'll admit that it was pretty fun.
It's just about time for our next segment. We would like to welcome back our friend Danielle with another interview.
This week's host might seem a little bit familiar to you, Margaret.
That's right, Aiden. This week, Danielle will be interviewing me. Let's take a look.
I don't know why I'm kind of... Hey, Margaret. Thanks for joining me today.
Hey, Danielle. How's it going?
Oh, pretty good. Why don't you start by introducing yourself?
My name is Margaret Berry. I am a junior at RRHS. I am 17. And I have a cat.
Beautiful. Wonderful introduction. Very detailed. Like, loved it.
Thank you.
All right, now, so you're a member of ORCTV, but how exactly did you get involved in the program?
I just, like, found out about it. And I was like, I want to work here because I love film. And I think it's a great experience to learn film.
Solid answer. Solid answer.
Yeah.
Now, what else are you involved in school besides ORCTV?
I'm involved in the drama club. I'm the costume leader, I guess.
Wow, props to you.
Thank you, thank you. I created the position.
Very nice, even more impressive.
I know. I'm also the president of writing club.
Oh, what do you write about?
All sorts of things. We do everything, different things each week.
Do you write poems?
We did, yesterday.
Haikus?
We did. Well, actually, I don't think we wrote haikus yesterday, but we did different types.
I'm a big fan of haikus.
Yeah?
Yeah. All right.
Haikus are great. Solid.
Margaret, what's your greatest strength?
That I'm haikus are my greatest strength?
Yeah.
I don't think so. I actually think that I'm a well-rounded person. Like,
this
I can understand
true.
Other people's experiences.
That's a good quality to have.
And like,
that's a good answer. I like that.
I just made it up.
You
I don't know where
that
came
like
from.
A job interview or something. That was good. That was good.
Thank you.
Now, what are you most talented at?
Photography.
Really?
Did you not know this?
I did not. This
I'm
is
a photographer.
I'm learning so much about you.
Yeah, I got paid to do senior photos. I did Bianca's and Bethany's.
Bees. Bianca, Bethany?
Yeah, bees. Also, my photos were in an art museum.
The
New Bedford.
Met?
No. Yes.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
You are so talented.
I know.
Wow.
I know.
Now, tell me, this is a big important question. Your answer to this, it will determine a lot of things. So, if you were a day of the week, what day would you be?
I really like Tuesdays.
Tuesdays. Interesting. Interesting. Why so?
Or Thursdays. Tuesdays or Thursdays. They're salad days. Because, like, I think Thursdays, actually. Because, like, it's close to Friday. Mm-hmm. And, like, I don't know. I usually have a lot planned. I usually stay after school. And then I go to drama. And it's just a solid day, you know?
Thursday. I'm a Thursday fan. I like Thursday.
And it's, like, the next day's Friday. So it's all happy.
Smooth sailing. You're good to go.
Mm-hmm.
And Margaret, what's your spirit animal?
It's a bear.
Any specific kind?
Like a brown bear, I think.
Brown bear? They have cute ears. Well, so
bears
do all bears.
Bears are adorable.
I mean, I love them.
I feel like I'm a brown bear because, like, I protect, but I also am very lovable.
You're like a mama bear.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cute. I like that.
But, like,
great answers, Margaret. Wow. Ooh.
Thank you.
Favorite movie?
I can't think of it. I go, this is my favorite movie. Oh, this is the first one that popped in my head. I really like Baby Driver.
Baby, oh my god, I love that movie. Mm-hmm. I've seen that far too many times.
Me too.
It's a problem. Can quote a lot of it. But it's a good movie.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Favorite color?
Green.
Favorite season?
Fall.
Favorite book?
Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban.
Third one? Third one's a solid one?
The third one. I've read it like six times.
It's a good one. not too big.
I didn't even read the second one. I did read the second one.
Oh, but God. Later. Why don't you just do me a favor and describe your ideal lunch?
Mac and cheese.
Just mac and cheese? No. Side, drink, beverage of some sort?
Just either I make one that's really good or like just like plain out. Cracker Barrel mac and cheese.
Cracker Barrel? Ooh.
Have you ever tried Cracker Barrel?
I haven't, but I am a Cracker Barrel fan.
It's real good. It's better than Velveeta. It's like natural cheese.
What about Annie's?
Oh, Annie's is good.
Some good stuff.
Some good stuff.
Very good. Mm-hmm. All right. What do you wish you knew more about?
Like events in the world. I'm not very
like current events.
I'm not very up on current events, and like I don't stand politically on things, and I don't because I don't know things, and I just haven't been involved in it.
Yeah, gotta watch the news, but it's very depressing.
My mom, my parents don't watch the news for us.
It's not the most fun channel.
Yeah.
It's not my favorite.
Mm-mm.
Where's the farthest you've been from home?
I went to England last year.
Did you develop an accent?
I used to be able to talk in a British accent really well.
What happened?
And I kind of lost it. Because I just stopped talking in it, and I stopped watching British TV.
Oh, man. You got to get back on it.
I watched Doctor Who a lot for like 2 years.
Great show.
I know.
I went through a Doctor Who phase.
You did?
My life, yeah.
I'm so proud of you.
Yeah. It was a good share. I enjoyed it.
It was.
Where's the most interesting place you've been?
Probably England. I went to Nashville 3 days before I went to England.
Wow.
So.
Big trip.
This is what I do instead of driver's ed.
Smart. Driver's ed. No fun.
Yeah.
Don't do it. Who is the funniest person you know?
I actually think it's you. I think you're pretty funny.
Stop it.
I don't really...
Oh my God.
There is different kinds of humor that I enjoy.
The Daniel Nutter humor?
You have a really special humor that I enjoy.
Thank you.
There's also like humor where like you just make eye contact and it's funny. Or like you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And
eye contact crucial.
Or like I don't know.
You know, fall.
Or like there's like humor where you like go back and forth on like a make-believe scenario.
Oh, yes.
I like that kind.
Those are good.
So, like, it's like those. There's a word for it when you go back and forth. A tatate? Tatate.
Au revoir.
Okay. Sure.
Yep, that's what it is.
Okay.
Learn something new.
Mm-hmm.
All right. What are you most likely to become famous for?
Hopefully being a director.
Ooh, I'll come see your movie.
Thank you.
Starring me. Now... What do you normally spend all your time doing?
I'm watching TV.
What show? Movie?
All sorts of things. I watch movies, I watch TV. I binge watch a lot of things.
TV shows or movies? It's tough, right?
I think movies.
Movies, right?
Because
a lot of people go with TV shows.
Because I think, like, movies have to be more thought out.
Mm-hmm.
And they have to have a more, like, natural story to it.
Yeah. TV shows, they, like, kind of force it sometimes.
Yeah.
Like,
It can either go good or bad in TV shows, but a movie, it's a solid hour and a half.
That's true. That's a good point.
You can have, like, season one is bad, but season two is good. Mm-hmm. Like,
you're just like, this is a good movie. It's a bad movie.
Yeah.
Black and white. Yeah, true. All right. Favorite piece of clothing that you have?
I really like these pants.
Those are some solid pants. Where'd you get them?
At a thrift store for $2.
Score!
I know.
I love it when that happens.
Me too.
The best time.
Yeah.
All right. Pet peeve?
When people say library.
Ooh, who does that?
I don't know. I've yet to meet one, but it still bothers me. Or when people, like, talk over you. Or, like, when you're getting...
That's terrible.
Or, like, when you get ignored.
That's bad.
Is that a pet peeve?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know if there's a solid definition, but it could probably fall under the category.
Okay.
All right, last one. If you had to change your name, what would you change it to and why?
Could I keep my name and add a hyphen with my middle name?
If you are so inclined.
So it would be Margaret May.
Ooh, it's got a nice ring to it.
I know.
May Margaret?
No.
No?
Well.
Then you'd be like, May Margaret, wash the dishes. She may. Margaret.
It's a tongue twister.
Exactly. Forget about Sally selling seashells. May Margaret.
May.
Mary Mitchell. She may Mary Mitchell. Margaret May. May Margaret.
Mary Mitchell. Mary Mitchell. Well, I gotta say, Margaret, I had a lovely time. Great talk. Come again sometime.
Of course.
Good job.
Thank you.
Thanks for sharing that great interview with us.
Now we're going to take a look at a Who Am I project. Each year, all of the seniors are required to make a video explaining who they are and what their place in the universe is. Let's see what our friends Brianna and Danielle came up with.
I don't know.
Do you know who you are?
No.
No.
Not, stop at the start.
So we were thinking about our project and like what we were gonna base it off of, and we decided to not focus on the big things that make us who we are, like where we go to college or where we grew up or what we want to be when we grow up. We decided that who we are the little choices that we make and the little moments in our life that kind of shape our personality and, yeah, who we are.
And these decisions, they might be things that you don't think twice about, like what you eat for breakfast or what street you turn on, but all of them added up together bring you to the moment that you're at right now.
It might seem like you're insignificant compared to the rest of the universe around you, but even the smallest things can affect the rest of the world.
7 billion people woke up this morning.
Maybe they brushed their teeth or decided what to have for breakfast. Maybe they took an excessive amount of time picking out their clothes. Or maybe they got in the car and decided to go left today instead of right. Seven billion people made decisions today that they wouldn't think twice about. But these decisions, these million tiny moments in our lives, determine the people we become. They can alter someone's mood, someone's day, maybe someone's entire future. They can change the course of history generations from now. For better or worse, you decide.
We live in a world full of pain, anger, and fear, but this world is also full of beauty, so vast one cannot possibly comprehend it all. You may feel smaller than a grain of sand compared to our entire universe, but we must do what we can to foster positive human existence. Every step we take in our own life affects the world around us. Lead with kindness, have an open mind, forget your flaws, and embrace your gifts.
Thank you.
Choices we make define us and like build us up into who we are. We also realize it's all the little moments in your life that you are the happiest, that are
they're like the collection of your entire existence, basically.
Yeah.
And it might be something simple as just like hanging out with your friends or petting a dog,
yeah,
or just watching a sunset.
Just little happy moments that you always think back on.
The little moments are the big moments.
And yeah, it's the same, like, everyone around the world has their own collection of tiny moments that add up to create something beautiful.
Mm-hmm. It's different for everyone, and that's what makes each one of us different. That makes us who we are.
You are not a name, or a height, or a weight, or a gender. You are not an age, and you are not where you are from. You are your favorite books and the songs stuck in your head. You are your craziest thoughts and what you eat for breakfast on Saturday mornings. You are a thousand little things, but for some reason everyone chooses to see the million things you are not. You are not where you are from, you are where you are going. 7 billion people experience today in a different way. It's our job to make sure 7 billion people experience a great tomorrow.
That was a really awkward laugh. That's the best I got.
What we might get at this evening, if we are lucky, if the mic doesn't fail, my voice holds out, if you ask me questions, is what the importance of this effort is. It would seem to me that, how arrogant this may sound, I want to suggest that the poets, by which I mean all artists, are finally the only people who know the truth about us. Soldiers don't, statesmen don't, priests don't, union leaders don't. Only the poets.
I go and we're dancing. Handshakes in the Hamptons and getting drunk in the mansions with you. And you looking so classy. Come to
Well done, Brianna and Danielle. I bet you aced that project.
It's time for the last and arguably best segment this week. I decided to try to make a new recipe for today's video. Let's see how it went.
students, if you'd like to have something filmed and shown on Bulldog Weekly, let us know at the ORCTV station.
Be sure to check out our Vimeo channel for everything we film here at ORCTV. We film sports games, town meetings, school events, and so much more.
That wraps up this week's episode of Bulldog Weekly. Until next time, I'm Margaret.
And I'm Maiden.
And this is Bulldog Weekly.